Classics Level 2 IMO. Mathematics question number 1. During the annual function, the participants were divided equally among two teams, A and B. The ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls in team A is 2:3 and that in team B is 3:17. What is the ratio of the number of girls to the number of boys participating in the function? Given the ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls in team A is 2:3 and in team B 3:17. Given the participants were divided equally among two teams A and B. Let the total number of students in team A equal to n and team B is also n. Since we don't know the actual number of boys and girls, we can take the common factor of the ratios of team A as x and team B as y. We get 2x plus 3x is equal to n and 3y plus 17y is equal to n. Simplifying this, we can get the value as 5x is equal to n and 20y is equal to n. That is nothing but 5x is equal to 20y. To make 5x is equal to 20y, we can take the value of x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 1. So, the team A ratio is 2:4:3:4. That is 8:12. Similarly, team B ratio is 3:17. Adding the ratio, the ratio of the number of boys to the number of girls participating in the function is 11:29. And the ratio of number of girls to the number of boys participating in the function is 29:11. Mathematics question number 2. Saurav travels 12 kilometers 352 meters by bus, 6 kilometers 6 meter by car and 420 meter by walking in order to reach his office. How far is his office from his residence? Distance travelled by Saurav by bus is equal to 12 kilometers 352 meters. Distance travelled by car is equal to 6 kilometers 6 meters. Distance travelled by walk is equal to 420 meters. The total distance from residence to office is 18 kilometers 778 meters. Mathematics question number 3. Which of the following figures does not have any line of symmetry? In the C figure, if this one circle was shaded, then this figure would be symmetrical. But as it's not shaded, it is not symmetrical. Mathematics question number 4. Select the correct option which makes the given expression true. Right hand side and left hand side, we're going to simplify into decimals. Then we're going to compare. As you can see here, the right hand side is greater than the left hand side. Mathematics question number 5. Miara had 20 packets of toffees. She gave 145 toffees to her friend. She was left with 5 packets and 35 toffees. If each packet had x toffees, then the situation described as the total number of toffees she had is equal to 20 into x, that is 20x. She gave 145 to her friends. So total toffees left is equal to 20x minus 145. Given total toffees left is equal to 5x plus 35. So, we get 20x minus 145 equal to 5x plus 35. That is the D option. Mathematics question number 6. Manish wrote 15 1 by 3 pages of his story on Saturday and 17 7 by 12 pages on Sunday. How many more pages did he write on Sunday than on Saturday? Subtracting the number of pages he wrote on Sunday by the number of pages he wrote on Saturday is equal to 27 by 12, which can be simplified into 2 1 by 4. Mathematics question number 7. What is the minimum number of squares that must be shaded so that line AB becomes a line of symmetry? As we can see here, we have to shade 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 boxes in order to make AB the line of symmetry. Mathematics question number 8. Find the values of P, Q and R. Area of rectangle 1 is equal to length into breadth, that is 247 meter square. We don't know the breadth, but we know the length. Using this, we can find the value of the breadth, that is 13 meters. Perimeter of rectangle 2 is equal to 2 into L plus B, that is 2 into 32 plus Q. From this, we can find the value of Q, that is 17. Now, area of rectangle 2 is equal to length into breadth. Since we already know the length and breadth, we can easily do it. So, the answer is 544 meter square. Mathematics question number 9. The product of two numbers is 4,14,720 and their HCF is 144. Find the LCM of the two numbers. We know that the product of two numbers is equal to HCF into LCM. 4,14,720 is equal to 144 into LCM. So we can find the LCM, that is 2,880. Mathematics question number 10. In the given rectangle ABCD, if length is increased by 3x and breadth is decreased by x, then find the new perimeter. Perimeter of the given rectangle is equal to 2 into 4x plus 2 plus 3x plus 1. New perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 2 into 4x plus 2 plus 3x plus 3x plus 1 minus x. So that is equal to 2 into 9x plus 3 or 18x plus 6. Mathematics question number 11. Puneet's age is 3 times the age of his son. If the sum of their ages is 56 years, then find the difference between their ages. Let Puneet's age is P and son's age is S. Given P is equal to 3S and P plus S is equal to 56. Substituting the P value in P plus S, we can get the value as 3S plus S is equal to 56. Now, using this, we can find the value of S, that is 14. Then we can find the value of P, that is 42. Difference between their ages is equal to 28 years. Mathematics question number 12. If 24x, 36 and 54 are in proportion, then find the value of x. 24x, 36 and 54 can be written as 24 by x is equal to 36 by 54. Using this, we can find the value of x, that is 36. Mathematics question number 13. The length and breadth of a rectangle is 32 meters and 16 meters respectively. If the perimeter of this rectangle is the same as the perimeter of an equilateral triangle, then find the side of the equilateral triangle. Perimeter of the rectangle is equal to 96 meters. Given the perimeter of the rectangle is equal to the perimeter of the equilateral triangle. Since the equilateral triangle has three sides, the perimeter will be 3 into side of the triangle. So 3 into side of the triangle is equal to 96 meters. Using this, we can find the side of the triangle, that is 32 meters. Mathematics question number 14. A room is 7 meter 20 centimeter long and 5 meter 20 centimeter broad. If square tiles have to be laid in such a way that an exact number of tiles fit in and no tile has to be cut, then what is the greatest length of the side of the square tiles? To find the length of the square tiles that fit into the room of 720 cm into 520 cm, we have to find the highest common factor of 720 and 520. The highest common factor is 40. So 40 cm tiles have to be cut so that no tile has to be cut. Mathematics question number 15. Solve for x. First, we're going to convert everything into improper fraction. Then, converting division into multiplication by reciprocating, we can get the value as 968 by 9 into x is equal to 968 by 117. Using this, we can find the value of x, that is 13. Achiever section question number 46. Simplify. First, from the sum of x by 2 plus y by 3 plus z by 4 and 2x by 3 plus 3y by 4 plus 4z by 5, subtract x by 6 plus y by 12 plus z by 20. First, we're going to add these. Taking LCM of 60, we can add the equation. We will get the value as 70x plus 65y plus 63z by 60. Now we'll subtract x by 6 plus y by 12 plus z by 20 from the above value. Taking LCM, we get the following equation. We know that the sign of number inside the bracket changes if there is a negative sign. So changing the signs and if we write, we'll get the following equation. Now simplifying, we get the value x plus y plus z. Now the second one. So according to Bonnet's rule, we can first do the inner brackets. Here, the sign of the number inside the bracket changes if there is a negative sign. Minus 3 into 3x is equal to minus 9x. Minus 3 into minus 4 is equal to plus 12. To add two integers of unlike sign, find the difference of their absolute values and place the sign of the largest value. If we simplify minus 9x and 2x, The absolute value is 7x and the greatest sign is the minus sign. So solving this, we get the answer as minus 6x plus 7. Achiever section question number 47. Read the statements carefully and state T for true and F for false. P1. A square pyramid has 5 faces, 5 vertices and 8 edges. A square base pyramid is 3-dimensional shape with 4 flat triangular faces, 1 square face, 8 edges and 5 vertices. So this statement is true. Q. A right angle is 1 by 3 of a revolution. We know that 1 revolution means 360 degrees. And 1 by 3 of 360 is 120, not 90 degrees, which is actually a right angle. R1. An angle made by minute hand in 45 minutes is 135 degrees. To make 60 minutes, the minute hand rotates 360 degrees. Therefore, to make 45 minutes, the minute hand should make 360 into 45 divided by 60, that is 270 degrees. So this is false. Q. A triangular prism and a rectangular pyramid have same number of faces. Yes, the faces in a triangular prism is 5 and the rectangular pyramid is 5. So this is true. Achiever section question number 48. A rectangular plot of land is 240 meters long by 200 meters wide. The cost of fencing the plot area meter is 30 rupees. Find the area of the land. The cost of fencing the land when fencing is done 4 times around the land. First, the area of the rectangular plot is equal to length into breadth, that is 48,000 meter square. Cost of fencing the land per meter is 30 rupees. Perimeter of the rectangular plot is equal to 880 meters. So, cost of fencing 880 meters is equal to 26,400 rupees. Fencing is done 4 times around the land. So, the total cost is equal to cost of fencing 1 time into cost of fencing 4 times. That is 1,05,600 rupees. Achiever section question number 49. Study the given number line carefully and match the columns. The scale ranges from 0 to minus 1 and is divided into 4 equal parts with each division representing minus 0.25. Here A is equal to minus 1.50, B is equal to minus 2.25, C is equal to minus 3.75 and D is equal to minus 4.50. In column 1, A is equal to A plus B. Here the sign of the number inside the brackets remain unchanged if there is a positive sign before it. So the answer for the A1 is minus 15 by 4. Since they have given the answer in fractions, we are also converting into fractions. B1, B into D, which is equal to minus 2.25 into minus 4.50. To find the product of two integers with same sign, we find the product of their values regardless of their signs and give a plus sign to the product. That is 81 by 8. Since the answer is in fraction, we are converting into fractions. C1. D minus A is equal to minus 4.50 minus of minus 1.50. Here the sign of the number inside the bracket changes if there is a negative sign before it. So we are writing minus 4.50 plus 1.50, that is equal to minus 3. D1. B by C, which is equal to minus 2.25 by minus 3.75. For dividing one integer by the other having the like signs, we divide their value regardless of their signs and give a plus sign to the quotient. That is 3 by 5. Achiever section question number 50. The given bar graph shows the number of people who like different beverages. Read the graph carefully and fill in the blanks. A. P dash beverage is liked by the least number of people. Lemon tea is liked by the least number of people. B. The difference between the number of people who like green tea and black tea is 4. C. If the total expenditure for preparing iced tea given on the above graph is Rs. 432, then the cost of 1 cup iced tea is equal to 18 rupees. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe, hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.